One and all, my name is Rio and welcome to another Matchday vlog. So tonight I will be making the really short journey up to Ellesmere Port as Chester FC take on our fellow Cheshire neighbours, Vauxhall Motors away, where we look to continue our decent pre-season. So in between tonight and our defeat at Buxton a couple of weeks ago, we turned over a Salford City 11 3-1 at home a week ago last Tuesday, which puts us in a good position ahead of tonight. So looking forward to it now, because I have never been to the Synchrion Arena before, so looking forward to visiting a new stadium, and also it is a really good local away day too, so really can't wait to now. So anyway, without further ado, I do hope you all enjoy my matchday vlog for tonight. If you do, please like, subscribe and also comment down your thoughts of the game below. So without further ado, let's get into today's matchday vlog right now. Enjoy. Stand up, I'm a brother. Our competitive season is now only less than 2 weeks away, so we don't have too long to finalise any terms with some of our trialists who do deserve to stay here for the long haul. Our last actual game was 2 weeks ago on Saturday, as we lost 3-2 away at Buxton in what was a rather interesting affair. The first half was rather close as both sides cancelled each other out, although it was Buxton who did make it 1-0 as James Hurst poked in on the stroke of half time. We did come out as the better side in the second period though, and moments in we got back onto level terms as George Waring stabbed home to make it 1-1. However, Buxton went on to retake the lead from the penalty spot as in the build up Simon Grand allegedly upended Rhys Stich, even though it was a 50-50, so in all fairness it should have never been a penalty. Eventually, Rhys Stich went on to slot in from the spot to make it 2-1 to Buxton, although moments later we got back onto level terms yet again as Danny Elliott blasted into the far side of the goal to make it 2-2. With full time looming, Buxton managed to grab a win as yet again Rhys Stich scored as he curled into the corner to make it 3-2 via a wicked deflection. The eventual scoreline was a tad unfair on us as we put on a decent fight in the second half, and also, as I said earlier on today, last Tuesday we did beat a Salford City 11 3-1 at home in a behind closed doors friendly, so hopefully we can get another win tonight. It will take about 20 minutes to get to Vauxhall Motors from here, so it will be a really short journey, because it is basically 6 miles away in Ellesmere Port, so really simple journey. So I will be getting a train tonight from Baich to Houghton, so a really short one, again a 10 minute train ride, then about a 20 minute walk from the station to the stadium, so really can't wait now, because I have never been to Vauxhall Motors before, which is quite ironic because as we do speak now, I have never been to Vauxhall before. However, by Friday night I would have been there twice, because I will be off to watch our youth team play Vauxhall Motors Youth in the FA Youth Cup at Vauxhall Motors too. So looking forward to my two visits over the coming days, and hopefully we will record two successes. So anyway, Vauxhall Motors do play at the Synchrion Arena, which holds 3,300, so I do think it is a lovely stadium for the league they do play, because you do have some lovely covered areas, a nice seated stand as well, and all in all a lovely tidy ground, which has improved in recent times, because you do have a lovely building behind the goal which has multiple bars and also a lot of rooms there. It is like a Premier League standard hospitality suite really, so can't wait to go in there tonight. And in general, Vauxhall Motors FC is a really good setup because you do have multiple 4G and also grass pitches near the stadium as well, because Vauxhall Motors do have a well-known academy team, and also I do believe Everton FC College do play there too, so a really good setup. So anyway, on one side is a covered all-seater stand which goes for half of the pitch and also straddles the halfway line with some supporting pillars which may affect your view. Meanwhile, for the other half of the pitch, so to both the left and also to the right hand side of the stand, you do have two uncovered flat standing areas. Meanwhile, opposite to that, you do have a covered terrace which again goes for about half of the pitch and also straddles the halfway line. However, you do actually have two terraces joined into one, because you do have a little bit of a gap in the middle, although you do have a roof which does join both of the terraces. So basically two stands in one, in all honesty. So again, a lovely stand, and again to both the left and also to the right hand side of the stand to make up the other half of the pitch, you do have two uncovered flat standing areas. Meanwhile, behind one goal is another uncovered flat standing area which goes for the entire length of the pitch this time, although as I said earlier on, you do have really huge large clubhouse there which has multiple bars and also a lot of rooms too, and also you do have a smaller clubhouse to the left of that too, where the changing rooms are, etc. And finally, behind the other goal, you do have another uncovered flat standing area, which is a much more simpler affair, because basically you do have a concrete fence to the back of the stand and the grass verge too. So anyway, I don't know whether tonight's game will be segregated or not, although I highly doubt it will be. However, in the unlikely event segregation is in place, then us Chester FC supporters will be allocated the smaller uncovered flat standing area behind the goal. So basically the much more simpler affair, and also a small section of the covered all-seater stand as well. So really can't wait for it. Now looks like a lovely stadium, and hopefully we will come home with a big win. Fighting for peace. Vauxhall Motors play in the North West Counties League Division 1 South, where their aim will be to simply win the title this season. The Motormen were one of the really unfortunate sides last campaign, as they were top by a whopping 16 points before COVID-19 cruelly voided their season. Our opponents are still rebuilding themselves, having resigned from the Football Conference back in 2014, but thankfully they are on their way back now, because since they dropped way down to the West Cheshire League Division 1 in 2014, they have won one promotion, although it may well have been two if last season wasn't affected. We will also be up against not one, not two, but three former Seals tonight, who are Glenn Rule, Joe Heath and also Ryan Crump. So first of all, left back Glenn Rule played for the old Chester City between 2007 and 2010, who has been at Vauxhall Motors since 2019. Meanwhile, goalkeeper Ryan Crump played for Chester back in 2017 to 2018 under Marcus Bignett, because basically he was only here from October 2017 until November, because he didn't even play a single game. So I would say that it was one of the most bizarre transfers in our entire history, because basically he was only paid to sit in the stands every week, because I don't think he was even named on our substitutes bench. So really, really weird transfer. But anyway, he left us back in November 2017, and Ryan has since played for Vauxhall Motors since July 2019, so I do think it will be rather interesting to see how he does fare off tonight. And finally, the third former Chester player who now plays for Vauxhall is player assistant manager Joe Heath, who is also a left back. So Heath endured a brief spell here back in the 2013 to 2014 season, where he made 23 appearances, having signed from the previous Hereford United. He departed us at the conclusion of that campaign, while he joined Foxhall Motors back in 2019, where he has been at ever since. So I would like to wish the three former Chester FC players all the best for the future, apart from tonight, of course. Caring about our loved ones. We have met with Vauxhall Motors twice before, where thankfully we are yet to lose a single game, so hopefully we can extend our flawless record tonight, because we have played 2 and 1-2. So anyway, our most recent meeting was way back on February the 23rd, 2013, in the Blue Square Bet Conference North, as we won 2-0 at home against Vauxhall Motors, so hopefully we can get a similar result tonight to continue our decent pre-season form. My score forecast for tonight's game is Vauxhall Motors 0, Chester FC 2, where I do think both Lloyd Marshews and also John Johnston will be both of our scorers. So I do think it will be quite a simple win for us tonight, because we might play quite a strong team, because it has now been 7 days since we were last in action. So I do think it will be quite a resounding away win tonight, and hopefully come 9:30 I will be right. Believe me, if only I could. As always, I will be off to the Synchrian Arena tonight, so my matchday vlog will be coming up right now, hopefully showing you all of the goals, so stay tuned. So anyway, without further ado, I do hope you all enjoy my matchday vlog for today. If you do, please like, subscribe, and also comment down your thoughts on the game below. So let's get into it right now. Come on, you Seals, let's do this. I'd make this world a better place. I have now arrived at the Synchrian Arena ahead of tonight's game between Vauxhall Motors and Chester FC, so it is now only 15 minutes before kickoff, although I did arrive way back at 6:30, so about an hour ago, and my word, when I arrived here there were already well over 100 people here, because only 300 people can attend tonight's game due to the COVID restrictions, so I am quite lucky to be here. So I do think there may be one or two people who may be disappointed and who may be locked out, which would be quite a shame, but yeah, you know, really nice atmosphere here tonight, plenty of fellow Chester FC supporters, which is fantastic to see, because we better make the most of it now, because with the way things are going, this may be one of the last matches we are able to attend, because COVID-19 is getting even worse now, so better make the most of it. But anyway, it is an absolutely superb setup here, because you do have plenty of 4G pitches in and around the ground, and also there's a lovely clubhouse here. You have absolutely everything, a fantastic sports bar, some nice rooms here as well. So all in all, a lovely setup here, and I do think it is a lovely ground as well for the league. Vauxhall do playing. So anyway, I do believe we are playing quite a strong team tonight, because we only have two more matches after today before our season does start. Well, if it does start, shall I say, because things are getting even worse now. But yeah, we do have two more friendlies after tonight, so not too many at all, but so we better make the most of it now anyway, like I say. But anyway, really can't wait, and it'll hopefully be a really good game of football, and hopefully we can get back to winning ways. Come on, City.
Joining together now, sharing the feelings, please believe me.
Unfortunately, I cannot find the Vauxhall Motors squad for tonight's game, but anyway, here is your Chester FC squad for tonight's match. We are in a 4-4-2 formation, so in goal is Louis Gray, in defence is Jamie Morgan, Danny Livesey, Simon Grand and Kevin Roberts. In midfield is John Johnston, Trellist A, Trellist B and Trellist C. And up front is George Waring and Will Goodwin. On our substitutes bench is John Worsnop, Joel Taylor, George Glendon, Lloyd Marsh Hughes, Danny Elliott, Trellist D, Trellist E and Trellist F. So enjoy the vlog, up the Seals. One greens. Hey!
Go on, Will. Oh! Follow up.
Go on. Go on, Will.
Everyone's going to die. Could you imagine?
I played on there a few years ago. Come on, boys. Hey!
Good job.
Oh! How unlucky. Finish. Oh.
Stay up. Stay up.
I've got a runner.
Up. Up. Up.
Yes, get in. Yeah. Full time, Vauxhall Motors 0, Chester FC 4. So another win for us tonight as we dominated the entire game against quite a decent Vauxhall team. So a good win tonight, and we go into Saturday's game against Trafford back on winning ways. More reaction soon. Come on, you Seals.
Start your journey. Early or maybe later. Oh, look for rainbows. Take your head dry, blow them all away.
You are buying a story, I want to keep hearing. You are see your colors, not just black or white. You are buying a reason, hope for all dreamers. You are my mini mass of
we
Vauxhall Motors 0, Chester FC 4, so another really dominant and promising performance by us tonight as we played some excellent football at times and cruised to an emphatic win. Vauxhall Motors made a decent account of themselves, in all fairness, especially in the second half, as they caused us a few issues and also were still really eager to get back into the game, even when it was effectively game over. Perhaps they were a tad too competitive for a friendly, as a couple of their players made some silly fouls, but on the basis of their showing tonight, I can see them faring really well this campaign. Anyway, our first half display was really impressive, as we were on top throughout and scored some really well-worked goals. Some of the football we played was superb, as well as our side combined really well to play some fluid stuff. Our opening chance of the game resulted in a goal as John Johnston fired into the top corner to make it 1-0 to us, thus netting his first ever goal in a Chester FC shirt. Will Goodwin then went really close to doubling our lead in what would have been an incredible goal, as an overhead kick was palmed away by former Seal Ryan Crump in the Vauxhall Motors goal. Goodwin was in the thick of the action once again not long after, as he went even closer by striking the crossbar. We were then able to find our second goal on the 20th minute mark though, as George Waring powered in a beauty of a header to make it 2-0 to us. After the half hour mark, Waring was involved in the goal malfaction again as he assisted Simon Grand, who hammered home to make it 3-0 to us. Vauxhall Motors had one or two spells at the other end, but not enough to trouble us as we cruised to a deserved 3-goal lead at half-time. We weren't firing on all cylinders as much in the second period, as Vauxhall Motors enjoyed more possession to threaten us a few times. As much as they tried to get on the score sheet, our defence remained valiant by doing what they needed to do. It wasn't a bad performance by us, as we still had a few attacks, although opportunities were quite rare compared to the amount we did have in the other half. Ryan Crump did really well to parry a dangerous Danny Elliott free kick away moments after coming on, while moments later Crump produced yet another superb save to deny Elliott again, with his effort hitting the crossbar. Lloyd Marshews was unlucky to not have grabbed our fourth goal of the night as he blazed over, although 10 minutes later it wasn't to be an issue as Trialist C finished off a nice move to make it 4-0 to us. That was to be that as we resumed our pre-season campaign in emphatic fashion. So anyway, on to my man of the match. So George Waring goes down as my man of the match for tonight because he was really dangerous up front and also topped it off by recording another goal and an assist for technically the second match in a row, because he did follow suit at Buxton a few weeks ago too, which was technically our last proper game. Also, Will Goodwin also had a really promising performance yet again, as he gave the home side's defence a few issues, was involved in some good link-up play and was unlucky to not have scored as he hit the crossbar. I was also impressed with Jamie Morgan, who went on plenty of runs, especially in the first half, and tracked back really well too. Also, John Johnston performed quite well as well, because he worked really hard on that right-hand side by making some dangerous crosses, and finally he managed to score his first goal in a Chester FC shirt, which will hopefully be the first of many, and also he did grab an assist too. Both Louis Gray and John Worsenop barely had anything to do tonight, although our defence was really well alert by dealing with any issues that Vauxhall Motors posed to earn a deserved clean sheet. So all in all, a really good and productive night at the office. Oh, yes, for now, love and pride. Our next match is on Saturday as we play Trafford at home in a behind-closed-doors friendly where we look to build on tonight's win. It certainly isn't the type of opposition that will set the pulses racing, but at least it is another game-like situation for our lads with our new campaign potentially round the corner. So anyway, Saturday I won't be able to go to the game, so I might be able to go to an alternative ground top, so stay tuned for further details. Unfortunately, as I said then, I will be unable to attend the Trafford game on Saturday, so I will be going on an alternative ground hop, so stay tuned for further updates. As we do speak, I am thinking of watching Hyde United v South Shields, which does catch the eye a little bit, but anyway, I am not 100% certain just yet, so anyway, stay tuned for further details. So all in all, it was an enjoyable night tonight on the whole, as the match itself was entertaining and there was a really healthy turnout of Chester supporters too, as I would say we did make up roughly half of the attendance. It may have been the last match some were able to attend for a good while now, because it does now look like a long while, so at least they were able to make the most of it, and also it was nice to catch up with a few familiar faces too. So anyway, if I do go to a game on Saturday, I will upload a matchday vlog in due course. And also, I do hope you all enjoyed my matchday vlog for tonight. If you did, please like, subscribe, and also comment down your thoughts on the game below. So anyway, I do apologise if I did sound a little bit different tonight. I do have a bit of a cold coming on, and also a bit of a scratchy throat as well. So I do have a bit of a sore throat, but hopefully things will be okay for Saturday. So I do apologise for that. Probably have corona with the way things are going, but hopefully nothing too much serious. So hopefully I will be okay for Saturday, and hopefully I will be feeling a little bit better. So anyway, a good win tonight. Let's keep it going. Come on, you Seals. Get in there.